Been vlogging for a long time, and now I have the occasion to do it again. First I do it to have the memories of the cities that I've been, places as well. So I'll vlog about New York. So here we are, it's Monday, it's Christmas, Christmas in New York. I had a wonderful concert. I really love singing here. There's a bunch of kids here in Central Park. It's really beautiful because it's sunny. First, it's warm. I'm wearing a winter jacket, but I want to be comfortable. And look at this old sky drapes. So I'm going to be taking you with me a little bit on a walk in the Central Park. This is like the biggest joy for the children.
Go!
Yeah. So after a long walk in Central Park, and I loved it, and after a small, after a little bit of shopping in TJ Maxx and Century 21, which is really good, if you guys if you go to New York, if you want to do some shopping, and if you don't want to spend a lot of money, then you should definitely... Oh, Christmas tree, nice background. It's just spontaneous. And if you want to not to spend that much money, then you should definitely go to TJ Maxx and the Century 21, which is somewhere over here. Scott Street. And I'm continuing for a little bit more walk, more of a walk. And I'm in front, I'm confused because I'm in front of this building, which I love, and I've been dreaming for years and years to come here. And now I am here, I guess, that you already know which building is. It's the Lincoln Center and the Metropolitan Opera House. Let's give it a moment. Sorry for my shaky hands. So, I'm gonna go closer to the fountain. I think there is something happening tonight. I'm gonna go closer, definitely. Unfortunately, I'm here just for a week because of my concert, which was on 21st of December, and that was a Saturday. I missed like half of the weekend. I don't know if you can hear me because of the fountain, but anyway, because of the concert, I couldn't arrange anything, and I wanted to see New York, like, more than I can, so that's why I'm doing that. No, my point is that I didn't manage to find some tickets to go to the opera, but next time, I hope that... Not I hope, I'm sure there's gonna be a next time. Metropolitan Opera, Lincoln Center. It was a big, long day, and I'm thinking to have a walk a little bit down the 7th and to Central Park. It's Times Square, because I want to see Times Square at night time. Yes, there's definitely something happening here. And I'm really tired, but never mind, since I'm here and I'm free, I don't have anything else to do but walk around. I'm gonna go, and then I'm taking the metro and going to the hotel to have a nice, warm, hot shower and watch a movie, probably, because, you know, walking every day is exhausting.
We'll have a modern mural too back there by an artist named Cecily Brown.
It's morning, and it's already crowded. I'm taking a walk down the 5th. The last time I was going up the 5th to the Central Park. Now I'm going downtown. I'm meeting a friend of mine for lunch, and after that I'm gonna explore the neighborhoods, Soho, Brooklyn Bridge, Carrie Bradshaw's apartment.
Let's just cross here.
And hopefully I'll come back to the center because yesterday, because of Christmas, it was overcrowded, literally. You just couldn't walk. So I decided to turn in a smaller street and take the subway to go home. And it was a good choice. Now I'm hoping that tonight is going to be a little less people on the street. I don't know. Can you hear me? Nice. But after, I think this is better. The weather is quite nice. It's sunny. It's warm, but it's windy. It's not cold. It's just windy. After the long walk on the Fifth Avenue, can you see me? After the long walk on the Fifth Avenue, which I literally started from the very beginning, where the Central Park is, if you go to New York, you should definitely do that, do the walk on the Fifth Avenue, because it's a nice view first. Second, like, you can see a lot of cathedrals, beautiful cathedrals. Then the Rockefeller Center on the right, if you're going face south, going downtown. Then there's a lot of Starbucks places, so we can just go inside and have a coffee or a tea. It depends which time of the year you're going. If you're going winter time, tea is always welcome. After that, I met in a wonderful sushi place for lunch with my friend, and she started showing me places. I didn't film nothing, but we went to see Carrie Bradshaw's apartment on 66th Paris Street. The neighborhood is really, really beautiful, though it's just, everybody knows that fact that they just used the exterior of the building, and now it has all the political signs against Trump, etc., etc. I don't want to go into it. And so if you want to have a picture, then you're going to have a picture with it, with all that political signs. But it was cool to see the place where it was filmed, where Mr. Big was coming with his limo to pick up Gary. And then if you go a little bit more downtown east, you can see where there starts the Hit Line, the park, which back then it was a train ship, and now it's gone, and now it's just a walking part. Like, no blocks, no crosswalks, you just walk over uptown, and it's a nice view. So it goes between the buildings, and it's no traffic, it's above the traffic, it's like a bridge. I can see the sun. And what else fun thing that we see? Well, you should go and see World Trade Center. I have videos from there. You can see from the not Washington Park. Oh my god. I forgot the place. Okay, if I remember, I'm gonna tell you in the next video. Where it's a place where the arch is, and from the one side you can see Empire State Building, but like in the middle of the through the arch. And if you go on the other side of the arch, you could have seen until 2001 the twin buildings, but then because of the attacks with airplanes, they collapsed. And now you can see the one building of the World Trade Center. It's a view. It's a nice view. It's a really nice view. I enjoyed it. And these neighborhoods after Soho and downtown are really, really beautiful. But the town houses are so expensive, and they're not worth it, in my opinion. Okay, I don't want to go into it either. But if you ask me, I would live there because it's really beautiful. It's so quiet and you can feel the spirit of New York and America, and it's so old school but yet fancy. And now I'm in Hudson Yards, where a few years ago it used to be just, you know, train yards, like a place where the trains were parked, but they did the Hudson neighborhood, and it's called Hudson Yards. It's only made of, it's only these skyscrapers which usually are empty. They're only flats, but it looks like it's an office place, office neighborhood. It looks like this. I'm gonna turn my camera. So this is Hudson Yards. And this is the new monument, which is practically just stairs, like 14 floors. There's a big line waiting for it. I didn't do it, and I'm not gonna do it because the tickets are not worth it. And you can have the view from any other part of the city, or you can just, if you want to do low budget views, you can just go up some loft, which has a, for example, a restaurant or a cafe. You can have a glass of wine or a cocktail and have a view of Manhattan or any other part of Manhattan. And on the other side, this is New Jersey. There are the ferry boats that connect Manhattan and New Jersey. To be exact, Lower Manhattan Ferry, and there is like the Midtown Manhattan Ferry, I think, and Uptown Manhattan Ferry. And of course, for the car drivers, there is the Tube. Hi everybody, so here we are in Grand Central Terminal. This is my lucky finish. Thank you very much. This is Grand Central Terminal, and it's really, really beautiful. They have this ceiling with stars and the zodiac signs, which is really beautiful. It's Christmas Day. And surprisingly, for Christmas Day, it's not that crowded. But if you have the time, go in Grand Central Terminal. It's nice. It's very American. And I'm here with my friend. Say hi.
Hi.
What's your name?
My name is Elisa.
Elisa. She's a New Yorker.
Yes, I am.
Yeah, she's my friend, she's a singer as well, and an actress, which is lovely. And we're walking around New York and having fun. Merry Christmas! Hello, what a view, huh? You're in New Jersey. Thanks to my friend Elisa, she brought me here to New Jersey, which was very, very good idea. Guys, if you're coming to New York, never miss coming to New Jersey just because of this, because it's worth, and it's a really, really a short drive. By bus, it takes like 10 minutes or less, and it drives by the river, Hudson River. We took the bus because the ferry, it's Christmas today and the ferry wasn't working. So I won't be speaking long about this, but you should definitely come to New Jersey just because of this. Take a little view, take a little look of Manhattan.
So this is Upper Manhattan, and then we go, that's Midtown Center, and as we move to the right, there is Empire State Building, a little bit to the left, here, that's Empire State Building, and I'm trying to find Rockefeller Center. I cannot find it. We go a little bit downtown, Hudson Yards. These are the buildings of Hudson Yards. I was talking about them. And Lower Manhattan is this part here, which is the World Trade Center, the tallest building here that you see in this picture now. And this is the place where the twin buildings were, which collapsed in 2001. So, hi again from me. Thank you, my darling Alyssa, for making this video for me. It's been very, very helpful. We're gonna go and take a walk around New Jersey, but mostly here around the river because I want to enjoy the view. Make some pictures for you guys, so don't miss it. If you're coming to New York, most definitely take the ferry if you want to enjoy the ride on the river, or in our case, because of Christmas, we took the bus. You can take the bus as well. It's just 10 minutes ride and enjoy this wonderful, wonderful view.
2001, 11th of September, 9:30 in the morning. Happened something awful in New York, in the World Trade Center, downtown New York, lower New York, not downtown, sorry, when the two twin buildings got hit by airplanes. Of course, they collapsed, the first one after 45 minutes. First one was hit between the 93rd and the 98th floor, and from that moment, from that day, there are a lot of pictures taken. The Falling Man is really a famous picture. It was an awful day, and America, of course, never forget. We'll never forget, and in honor of that, and I didn't finish, after 1 hour, the second building was hit, and it collapsed as well. So it was really, really awful day for New York, for America, for all the world. And as I was saying, in that honor, are built these two fountains, on the exact place where the twin buildings were. What else I wanted to say, and then I'm gonna turn my camera and show you the Memorial Center. I didn't have a chance to go inside in the Memorial Museum because the queue is just enormously big, and I don't wanna spend my whole day waiting in the queue. So I'm just walking. This is like my third time here, because it's so touching, you know, thousands of people died, 3,000 people died, to be exact. Okay, I'm turning my camera and I'm gonna continue filming. So I'm in the middle, in the park, of the Memorial Center, of the World Trade Center, sorry. I'll start with this one. This building is the new World Trade Center. The people were so against of rebuilding the Twin Towers, so decided to pick a new, brand new architecture tower, and it's this one. You could see it from the other side when I was in New Jersey, and I show it to you from that side. This is building number one. I'm gonna be saying as number one and number two because I don't know which one is the south, which one is the north, and they're separated like that. You can see this enormous fountain and the exact place where the building was. All the names are engraved here. And of course, all the visitors are invited to touch the grave names of those who died. The most touching moment is that the fountain is made so good. Here you can see the sign as a tribute.
I'll get one of you guys.
And the next one is just like 20, 30 meters away. I'm getting there. The protection, the security here is quite on a high level. You cannot do things that are not normal. For example, you cannot sit whatever you want, you cannot run around or stuff like that. There's police officers all around in this park. So as I'm moving closer to the new World Trade Center, I'm approaching the other fountain. See, there's the water falling down into a big hole and then one smaller in the middle, which by the way it's made that way so you cannot see where does it go. That's the World Trade Center Mall with the shops and dining places, and buildings around. But the main thing are these fountains, from which I'm deeply, deeply touched. So that's pretty much my last destination. After a long day in Century 21, if you know what I mean. It's a department store with all the brands, almost all the brands, with enormous discounts. I'm tired. And it's cold. Today is already colder. I had luck. I was so lucky that all the week was cold. The previous week was so warm, the weather was not so nice and sunny, and today was still sunny, but it's cold already. So I got to the Brooklyn Bridge. I might go a little bit closer behind this building, but I'm gonna have to think. Sorry about the gum. I'm gonna have to think about it. Anyway, it's by the water, it's nice, but it's colder because of the water. The view is beautiful, I must admit. So, I like New York. I definitely like it. There's a lot of opportunities, a lot of possibilities. It's beautiful. You know, I was always interested and more in what's around the famous places than the famous place by himself. So, around Brooklyn Bridge, is this wooden harbor with boats around. The sail, there's one behind me just passing by. These ferries are connecting. Some of them are just driving through Hudson River, and some of them are connecting Brooklyn and Manhattan, or Manhattan and New Jersey. Anyway, it happened. Dreams come true. I came to New York, and I'm hoping that I'm gonna come again, because I did so many things, and there's so many left to do. So for goodbye New York for now, me and Brooklyn Bridge, my last destination. I'm gonna go sometimes again to supply some magnets and stuff like that, and chocolate. I'm going home. First, I'm going to Moscow. And I'm going home. 4 years ago. Okay, guys. I love you all. I hope that I show you fun places in New York. I mean, on the other side, I'm still doing this for me. Because at the end of the day, after a while, when I watch my videos on YouTube, I just remember how I felt when I was there, and it's nice that I record this, and it's nice that I'm keeping a video diary. I'll call it like that. Okay. That's gonna be me. My goodbye for now.